We all know that sleep is essential for looking good and feeling good. Now, recent studies show that sleep also plays a significant role in diabetes control. Joining me is Dr. Michael Thorpe, director of the Sleep Wake Disorder Center at the Montefiore Medical Center in New York. Welcome, Dr. Thorpe.
Thank you. Pleasure to be here.
Absolutely. I'm glad to have you. Now, what happens to blood glucose levels during sleep?
Well, the blood glucose level is a balance between the production of glucose from the liver and its utilization throughout the rest of the body. So when we go to sleep at night, of course, we're quite still and our body is in a relaxed state. So there's less utilization of the glucose by the muscles, and also our brain uses far less glucose at night because we go into a much slower brainwave pattern. So the end result is that our blood sugars tend to go higher while we're asleep at night.
Some studies show a lack of sleep is a risk factor in people with diabetes. What's the connection?
Well, we're now starting to realize that if you reduce the amount of time that you're in bed and you have less sleep, or if you have a sleep disorder, insomnia, or sleep apnea where sleep is disturbed, that this can affect one's metabolism. And certainly those who have what we call maturity onset or type 2 diabetes tend to be overweight. And overweight certainly predisposes people towards certain types of sleep disorders. For example, obstructive sleep apnea syndrome, where there is cessation of breathing during sleep.
That can
occur in people who are overweight. But also, of course, there's a lot of stress associated with diabetes. So emotional factors are very important. Depression can occur, and depression, we know, greatly affects sleep quality. And blood glucose control then starts to become impaired.
So can too much sleep also be a risk factor as well?
Well, there is some evidence that too much can also do it. But the greater problem is too little. Most people in our society are getting too little sleep. In fact, over the last 40 years, the amount of sleep that people are getting has been reduced by about 2 hours. So 40 years ago, surveys were showing that people were getting on average about 8.5 hours of sleep. Now people are getting only about 6.5 hours of sleep.
So now, what is the right amount of sleep?
The right amount of sleep for most people is about 7.5 hours of sleep. So if one's getting less than that, it may be too little. But there's a lot of individual variation. It's probably genetically determined by genetics that we determine how much sleep we require. So there are people that may require as much as 10 hours, some people as little as 6 hours. But for the majority of people, it's about 7.5 hours.
Now, what are the hygiene recommendations? Sleep hygiene, that's a new one.
Keeping regular time of going to bed, getting up in the morning, being in bed an appropriate amount of time. But also getting good exercise during the daytime is important. Getting bright light exposure. Light is a very important controller of sleep-wake patterns. Avoiding things like alcohol, caffeine, nicotine around sleep.
The normal stuff.
Yeah, because they're all going to disrupt sleep. So we lump all these everyday sort of behaviors into a category that we call sleep hygiene. And people need to pay attention to these.
Now, what about neuropathy and restless leg syndrome?
Well, yes, there's a higher prevalence of restless leg syndrome in people who have diabetes. Restless leg syndrome is this discomfort in the legs that people get when they lie down in bed at night and they have this feeling they can't keep their legs still. They have to move them around in bed. And typically what they do is to get up out of bed and walk around, and that relieves the sensation. But when they get back into bed again, the same discomfort comes back in their legs. Now, there's a higher likelihood of having that if you have diabetes, particularly if you have diabetic peripheral neuropathies.
It sounds as if sleep is as important as diet and exercise in a person with diabetes.
Exactly. And that's what we're now starting to realize as sleep specialists. We recognize the fact that up there with diet, exercise is sleep as well. And people have to recognize that that's an essential part for everyday good health.